You first, ladies and gentlemen, on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing blue trunks, and fighting out of and representing Houston, Texas, in the United States. He weighed in at 17 stone, 3¼ pounds, or 241¼ U.S. pounds. His record stands at 39 wins, 3 losses, with 32 big wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, he is currently ranked the number 17 heavyweight contender by the WBC. Here is the former USBA heavyweight champion, introducing Lou Savarese. And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, across the ring, really needing no introduction the world over. On my right, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring, wearing his traditional black trunks, fighting out of and representing Catskill, New York, in the United States. His weight, 15 stone, 12 pounds, 222 U.S. pounds. His record stands at 47 wins, 3 losses, 1 no contest, with 41 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the youngest man ever to win the heavyweight title, currently ranked the WBO number 1 contender, presenting the 2-time heavyweight champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, he's back, introducing the one and only Iron Mike Tyson.
You know, the thing I noticed, Frank Warren clapped for Lou Savarese, and there's not clap for Mike Tyson. You know, I've been watching that. I've just been watching Frank Warren's actions for the last 2 or 3 minutes there.
Display good sportsmanship.
Maybe secretly supporting Lou Savarese in this fight.
Right, here we go then. The meanest heavyweight of his generation, Mike Tyson, twice, of course, the heavyweight champion of the world, still on the comeback trail against Lou Savarese, as we will call him. The Italians behind us are pronouncing it Savarese, and that'll do for me, Frank. Savarese, I believe, is the American pronunciation, but we won't worry about that. Referee John Coyle from Wolverhampton in the Midlands, and this one is scheduled for 10 3-minute rounds. Don't expect it to last that long, do we?
We don't. Now we're ready. That bell's going to go and the excitement's going to go right through this arena.
And
you can hear the crowd now. You can hear the crowd really getting up for this one.
Here we go then. Round one. Savarese, of course, in the sky blue trunks. He has the size to cause...
Oh, there is the first one.
No, he hasn't.
There it is.
First punch of the fight from Tyson. And poor old Savarese is flat on his back. One is up at about 4 and he's in big, big trouble. It's all over shortly. Next punch.
That was quicker than he put Julius Francis down.
Yeah. Oh, he's got to make. Oh, he's got it.
It's all over.
It's all over again.
He's stopping it.
He's finished. It's finished. It's finished.
And the referee's trying to stop the fight.
Yeah.
Tyson's still free.
He's
knocked the referee down.
He's
knocked the referee down. He's still trying to throw punches.
I can't believe this. This is mayhem. And well, Tyson's just realised it's all over. He's just realised it's all over. Savarese says, hey, I'm okay.
He can't stop this fight, the referee is.
Is he going to let it? No, it's all over. It's all over. It's all over. So John Coyle ushers poor old Lou Savarese to the corner. The fight is over.
The crowd do not like that. They've come to see what this. Tyson wants the fight on.
Tyson was so intent
on
doing a job. Tyson was so intent on destroying Savarese, he didn't even comprehend the referee's instruction to stop boxing. He just kept on throwing punches, didn't he?
It's a bizarre finish, but, you know, it's what people paid to see.
That's right. They paid to see.
Wherever there's Mike Tyson, there's controversy.
It's funny, you know, it's funny. I mean, let's face it, Savarese was on his way to a good hiding. When John Coyle jumped in, he was hit and he was hurt. Now, you know, we always say, Frank, when a man's chance is patently gone, it's time to get in to save him from himself often. But do you think that was a bit quick?
John Coyle's a good referee. He's not known for stopping fights quickly. But Savarese was on the ropes getting hit. He was getting battered. He recovered because of the confusion, the way they were trying to pull Tyson off when Tyson fell to the... slipped there to the floor in between.
That's right.
You know, he would have been hurt if he'd continued. I mean, it's all right for all that, everyone sitting out here and everyone around saying, and the cornermen saying he should be allowed to go on. But he had no answer to the power of Mike Tyson.
Yeah, sure, but I suppose most of our American viewers would be imagining that you know, you had to nail Savarese to the floor to consider this one over. I mean, I don't subscribe to that personally.
No, I think a referee had...
Well, here we go again. and he was absolutely destroyed by the first punch that Tyson landed, high on the head, bang,
top
down
of the head,
he went.
Right on the corner, and that's a very dangerous place to hit someone, and that disorientates your whole body when you get hit there.
Yeah. That's it again, and you said then, Frank, on the corner of his head. Yes. What are you trying to say?
Right there on the temple. Went across, and the first one...
First
punch called him.
Well... Well, let's just watch this again. I think this was the follow-up, wasn't it? Oh, no, it wasn't. No, that was a that punch definitely landed on the head.
Yeah, it landed there.
That punch definitely landed on the head, didn't it? Watch again from this angle. Bang, yes, the glove was actually further back. It didn't hit the glove at all. Some people might have thought it did, but it didn't. It actually caught him sort of on the brow. Just watch, this is the best angle, in fact, I think, for it.
This is a good uppercut.
Yeah, and he was
that hurt. That uppercut actually missed, yeah. But that punch called him there. The body punch called him there.
And
now that's definitely the one. Called
he
him.
Was on
that,
his way down,
and
wasn't
that
he?
Called him.
And that's when John Cole decided to get in. But I'm afraid John made a bit of a pig's ear of that, didn't he?
Maybe the referee was a little bit too soon to
he
stop.
He should have grabbed Tyson and not Savarese. That's what he should have done. He should have grabbed Tyson instead. But
he should have let this fight go on a little bit longer. I do believe now after seeing that. I mean, Savarese. Oh, mind the referee got knocked out there.
John Coyle hits the deck. He never could take a punch, John Coyle, could he?
Well, you know what? This has done Julius Francis' stock very well. He lasted a lot longer than this.
Yes, he did, didn't he? Well, they're even almost having a conversation there, Tyson and Coyle. Well, it's interesting. Crocodile there is trying to call you out, Frank. He's having a go at you now. Bring Lewis on, he's saying. Bring Lewis on. That's very interesting. Are you going to respond to that? Get up there, Frank, and knock him out.
Not really. I mean, I'm not here to, you know, I'm not here to do Lennox Lewis. I'm, you know, here to report on this fight.
Yep. Here we go. A bit of replay again from these final moments. John Coyle, they're taking a whack from Tyson, unintentionally, obviously, but fascinating. And you know, I do think John Coyle's made a mess of that, to be honest.
Yeah, I think it's a bit premature. I mean, the crowd would like to see Savarese flat on his back being countered out, but you know the referee has a split second to act.
Yeah, that's right.
Split second to act.
We've got the benefit, of course, of replays. But as you so rightly said, Frank, like in football, you know, is it a penalty or isn't it a penalty? The referee has only got to see it once, you know, and he's got to make up his mind. And that's what's happened here. John Coyle has feared for the safety of Savarese, so he stopped the fight, and he's right to do that. If that's how he feels, but he actually did it the wrong way. He should have jumped on Tyson and not Savarese. Here we go then, I think, for Jimmy Lennon to give us the official verdict. It's a technical stop, a technical knockout in favour, of course, of Mike Tyson, and we've just got a few seconds to go before the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 38 seconds in round number one. A referee in charge, John Coyle, stops the contest, and the winner, Iron Mike Tyson.
Well, who'd have thought that? 38 seconds, Frank.
I mean, look at those eyes. That's an evil man.